is Peter Kelly, and I'd like to welcome you to the Woodland Escape. As you can see by my attire, the shelter that I'm in, and some of the accoutrements that are hanging about my fire pit, I've literally stepped back in time. So most of my adult life, I've had a passion in terms of history and the outdoors. And about, 30 years ago, that kind of dates me, but I sort of combined the two, where my outdoor pursuits, I try to do in the way, method, and techniques that would have been used in the time frame. The time frame that I'm most interested is mid-1700s to the early 1800s. My journey has been both fascinating and at times a wee bit frustrating. The frustrating side of it is finding information, first-person information, about people that lived during the time period. They didn't really write much about the common folk. There's a wealth of information out there in terms of the affluent, the aristocratic society, if you would, certainly military campaigns, but people didn't write a lot down about the common folk. So over the years, I've tried to uncover through research little tidbits of information that I can see how they did things. When I find those little pieces, for example, a skill that I don't have, and work it through, and through a lot of trial and error, actually come out with a usable skill. So through a series of videos, I hope to demonstrate the day-to-day life of people that lived through the 18th century and early 19th century. These were very turbulent times. We had the French and Indian War that lasted for 7 years, followed very quickly by the American Revolution, again an 8-year period, and very quickly after that, the War of 1812. It was also a very volatile time along the frontier in terms of indigenous people. And rightly so when you think about it, because through lies, deceit, broken treaties, and by force frequently, we literally stole their land as European immigrants. And as a result, they were very violent times along that frontier. But the natives gave us a lot. They gave us a lot of the foods and medicines we know today in North America. They gave us things like the toboggan, the canoe, snowshoes, items that literally haven't changed well into the 21st century. So the list of the things that I intend to cover is quite long. I'll try to summarize it somewhat, but I have built a number of log cabins, and in fact, I'm going to be starting one in the next week or two. And I hope when it's done, it'll be sort of a pretty authentic reproduction of a homesteader's cabin in the 1700s. We'll be videotaping this, and if you like, you can follow along. I also build birch bark canoes. I finished one this summer. Did some filming, but next spring I will be starting another one, and we'll be filming that as well. It'd be wonderful if you'd tag along and have a look at it. So I'm gonna cover the gamut. In terms of summarizing, food gathering would be a big component. Hunting, fishing, of course, but also growing food and foraging for food. I'm always amazed at how much food one can find right off the land, as well as medicines. There are a lot of very effective medicines that can be found and utilized, again, thanks to the natives for their teachings in that respect. So without further ado, I'll try to get into what I'm going to try to portray in this first video, and that will be the journey of a solo hunter as he heads off into the hinterland in search of new hunting and trapping ground. So typically, in that era, homesteaders would, once the root cellar was full, the woodshed was full, the meat pole had good supply of meat hanging on it, the cabin had been battened down, the hunter would leave the family for the winter, usually about this time of year, and it's starting to get hard frost now at night, and they would return generally around maple sugaring time back to their family, a long stay. They'd work in the for the trapping companies, because fur was gold in that period, and they could take their goods that they were able to harvest in the winter, sell those for things that they either couldn't make or grow. Or they may have been employed as a hunter for the trapping companies. And their primary role was to go out and get meat and keep the stew pots filled. So what I'm going to do and demonstrate in this first film is you're going to follow this solo hunter as he heads off in his journey. I hope you'll join me, and we'll paddle back in time. And I thank you very much for coming to the Woodland Escape.